Number 10, they can be quite dangerous. When people think of dangerous sea creatures, their minds automatically drift towards sharks, dolphins, snakes, and stingrays. However, octopuses can be quite dangerous too. Octopuses do not have sharp teeth or stingers, sure, but they can be quite venomous, bringing quick, painful death to their victims. All species of octopuses are venomous, but only the infamous blue-ringed octopus has venom lethal enough to kill a human. Octopuses are preyed on by a wide variety of creatures. These include fishes, seabirds, sea otters, pinnipeds, cetaceans, other octopuses, and humans. And so, to protect themselves from predators, they have a variety of tactics and mechanisms. However, their venom, produced by their salivary glands, is usually a last resort. Octopus venom contains a toxin known as tetrodotoxin, as well as more common neurotransmitters like histamine, tryptamine, octopamine, taurine, acetylcholine, and dopamine. This venom can cause nausea, respiratory arrest, heart failure, paralysis, blindness, and death. Even though bites are hardly noticeable and deaths can take place in a matter of moments, victims can be saved if artificial respiration comes in to save the lungs from paralysis. Number 9. Octopuses die after mating. Octopuses have a life cycle that best represents the idea that the purpose of life is to reproduce. Both males and females die soon after mating, birth, and brief periods of parenting. Octopuses are birthed by external fertilization. This is a mode of reproduction that is facilitated by aqueous environments. The general principle is that the male organism's sperm fertilizes the female organism's egg outside of the female's body. In spite of this general principle, octopuses have a special way of getting external fertilization done. Multiple males either insert their spermatophores directly into a tubular funnel that the female uses to breathe, or else literally hand her the sperm, which she always accepts with one of her right arms. After this happens, male octopuses wander off to die. Females still have to see birth and parenting through. Female octopuses can lay up to 400,000 eggs. Prioritizing motherly duties, female octopuses stop eating and fiercely protect and tend to the eggs. Once the eggs hatch, the female octopus's demise begins. She doesn't quite starve to death. Instead, her body begins a degenerative process. It starts from the optic glands and ripples outwards through her tissues and organs until she dies. Number 8. Octopuses have blue blood. The red coloration of human blood is due to a special pigment known as hemoglobin. Hemoglobin is an iron-based protein that is proficient at transporting oxygen through the bloodstream and towards the essential tissues for metabolic processes. Octopuses lack hemoglobin, and so they lack red-colored blood. Instead, they possess an alternative pigment known as hemocyanin. Hemocyanin is a copper-based pigment protein, differing from iron-based hemoglobin. It is colorless when unoxygenated, but turns blue once oxygen attaches, giving octopuses their blue-colored blood. This copper base of hemocyanin is more effective at transporting oxygen than hemoglobin when the water temperature is very low and not much oxygen is around. But in spite of this oxygen-carrying efficiency, there's a drawback that has to do with acidity. Hemocyanin causes octopuses to be highly sensitive to acidity. As such, if the pH of the surrounding water dips too low, hemocyanin breaks down and octopuses can't circulate enough oxygen, and so they die by asphyxiation. This is a problem octopuses will hardly ever face unless they are out of their natural environments. However, things like oil spillages and climate change can cause their deaths in this manner. Number 7. Octopuses have three hearts. Most organisms, even those way larger than octopuses, only have one heart. Examples of such creatures include sperm whales, sharks, and dolphins. However, octopuses, which average 33 pounds, about the weight of one cinder block, and have a length of 14 feet, about a third the length of a small bus, have three whole hearts. Of course, those other creatures have large hearts, which are scaled to their massive sizes. But then, each of the octopus's three hearts performs specialized functions. Other mollusks, like squids and clams, have open circulatory systems. This means blood is not closed off into arteries and veins and spreads throughout the entire body. However, octopuses form the exception of this animal phylum. Their three hearts are linked to the rest of their bodies by arteries, veins, and capillaries. Two of the octopus's hearts are branchial hearts, which pump blood through the gills for respiration and gas exchange. The third octopus heart is the systemic heart, which receives the blood that's drawn from the gills and pumps that oxygenated blood to the body system. The systemic heart actually stops beating when the octopus swims, explaining the species' penchant for crawling rather than swimming. Swimming actually exhausts these creatures. Number 6. Octopus brains are not localized. In the animal kingdom, it's quite common for creatures not to have localized brains. An example of such a creature is the cockroach, which can survive for up to 10 days without a head before dying out of hunger due to not having a mouth. Octopuses are very much the same way. Although they have large heads with tentacles attached, some of their brain matter extends into their tentacles. In fact, 2/3 of an octopus's neurons reside inside its tentacles and not its head. This gives the creature several advantages. For one, because of the proximity between their sensory organs and their brain, they have a quick reaction time. Another advantage is that they have excellent multitasking abilities. Arms can perform relatively complex tasks, such as opening shellfish, while the head does something else, such as looking out for danger. Octopus's arms can even maintain some functionality when severed from the body. In an experiment, severed arms jerked away in pain when researchers pinched them. Like lizard tails, these severed octopus arms could also help the creature escape danger. They are also capable of regeneration. Number 5. Octopus ink serves multiple purposes. Of all the adaptations which octopuses have to hunt and to escape predation, one of the most iconic is their ink. Octopus ink is generated by a special gland and then stored in their ink sac, which is located close to their digestive glands. Octopuses largely use their ink to escape from prey. Before octopus ink escapes from the gland, it passes through a series of glands that mix it with mucus, creating a thick, dark blob. This mucus matrix is essential as it traps the ink within a cloud and prevents it from dissolving too easily. The octopus ink can hamper predators in a variety of ways. For one, by clouding their vision. The ink is quite thick and impossible for even the best pair of underwater eyes to see through. The ink also hampers olfactory acuity, making the best pair of underwater noses confused as to where these creatures escape to. And finally, the ink itself sometimes attacks the predators as it contains a chemical known as terosinase, which can cause irritation. Number 4. Octopuses can build underwater cities. Octopuses are some of the smartest known creatures. Some of their feats of observed intelligence include the ability to open jars, the ability to use rocks to defend themselves, the ability to make tools using coconuts and shells, the ability to solve mazes, and the ability to mimic other sea creatures to fool both predators and prey. Out of all of these abilities, one of the most fascinating things they can do is get together and build underwater cities. In 2017, a team of marine biologists discovered a group of 15 gloomy octopuses off the coast of Australia who, previously thought to be a solitary species, were living together in a makeshift city they called Octlantis. These octopuses were exhibiting complex social behaviors, such as communication, using tools, and evicting each other from their dens. These complex social structures allow octopuses to stand better chances of survival. In a group, they can easily repel predators, find food, as well as take better care of their young. In the often ruthless marine environment, only species with adaptations like this may be around several generations into the future. Number 3. Octopuses are masters of disguise. If the repertoire of octopus defense tools which we've discussed already isn't impressive enough, consider the fact that these creatures are masters of disguise. They spend about 40% of their time in their dens, And then, once approached, they send out a tentacle to investigate. If they identify that they are being hunted by prey, they have two different camouflage-related techniques they can use. Octopuses can change their skin color and texture in under a second. This is a large contrast to chameleons, which require several minutes to achieve the same. Once approached by prey, octopuses can resort to aposematism, or warning coloration. This is when they change their color to signal to predators that they are not worth eating. In the animal kingdom, bright colors are usually associated with toxicity, and octopuses use this to their advantage. The other camouflage technique they use is diamatic behavior. This is when they alter their shape to make themselves appear as something they are not. Sometimes they make themselves appear like coral. Number 2. Octopus suckers are strong and sensitive. Octopus tentacles are not smooth. Instead, they are bumpy, covered with suckers. These suckers are very strong and sensitive. They can hold up to 35 pounds of force, equivalent to the octopus's own weight. They can also detect tiny chemical changes in the water. An average adult octopus has about 240 suckers per arm. The suckers can usually be found on the interior surface. These suckers can move individually, making pinching gestures. Being adhesive, they also allow the octopus to grab onto objects or anchor themselves. The sensitivity of these suckers extends beyond chemoreception. They can sense and respond to light, allowing the octopus to move even when the head is obscured. Octopuses have fish-like eyes, which are on the tops of their heads. They have excellent vision, even better than that of humans. Number 1. Octopuses are an ancient species. Octopuses being so intelligent starts to make sense when you realize that the species has been around for about 300 million years. This was before life had even begun to spread on Earth. They have had lots of time to evolve and develop the basics of higher cognitive functions. This explains why they have so many defensive adaptations and why they are capable of using tools and building cities. Octopuses also require a lot of stimulation and are quite playful. They tend to interact with humans quite easily. When their environment doesn't give them this stimulation, then octopuses find a way to give it to themselves. They have been known to nibble their own tentacles from time to time, although of course the tentacles grow back. Would you rather be attacked by a stingray or octopus? Let us know in the comment section below.